happy to support that.
I call Dan Bidwell. Are you seeking the call?
Malo ni to huhuka te tukituki whono.
Malo ni.
Madam Speaker, happy Tokelau Language Week. Just had to get that right. And it's a pleasure to speak on behalf of the Social Assistance Residential Qualification Legislation Bill. I'd like to apologise on behalf of my poor linguistic ability to all the people of Tokelau. I'll stick to English, which is my mother tongue, in this for the duration of this speech. Madam Speaker, I was also reminded with the colour that was in the House just about 5 minutes ago that it is also appropriate for me to say happy Diwali for everybody in New Zealand. It's been a fantastic celebration last weekend, and I'll be continuing to celebrate that this weekend. We've got about 2,000 people in my electorate of Northcote that celebrate that, and it's just a fantastic celebration. So, Madam Speaker, it's a pleasure to talk on behalf of what is an important bill today. The purpose of this bill, and the way I see it, is threefold. The first is around flexibility, the second is around fairness, and the third is around contributing to local economies in the realm. We are very happy to support this bill, Madam Speaker, because it allows people who are from the realm of Cook Islands, Niue and Tokelau the ability to come to New Zealand and contribute to the New Zealand economy, but also go back to their home countries or their countries of origin, continue to contribute to those economies, and at the same time fulfilling the residency requirement for New Zealand Super or for the veterans pension. It's also about fairness, Madam Speaker, and it's about those who contribute to New Zealand and who have the ability and to access the New Zealand Super to also be able to access Super wherever they are in the realm. And finally, it's around contributing to local economies. And I see this as actually a very important bill for helping to provide remittances back to these local economies, to provide the skills and expertise of all these people who have worked here, who have got New Zealand connections, expertise, to go back to their home countries once they've turned 50 or over 50, and to be able to contribute to their local economies. And I would love to certainly acknowledge, Madam Speaker, your origins in coming from the Cook Islands, and also our colleague on this side of the House, Alfred Naro, because both of them come from the Cook Islands as well. And of course, Madam Speaker, we cannot underestimate the importance of our relationship with the Cook Islands, Tokelau and Niue, both from a historic perspective, dating back to somewhat 1946 in terms of the South Pacific Commission, but also the political and the economic relationship that that we share together today. And it really is by way of a constitutional relationship, Madam Speaker. The people in these countries are New Zealand citizens, and that this bill extends the same level of rights that they have in order to get access to the pension. So, Madam Speaker, what is the policy problem that this bill is trying to solve? Well, certainly it's around the 10-year residency requirement for pensioners or to get the pension. And I would like to acknowledge the fantastic contribution from my colleague Maureen Pugh, who outlined that there is a members bill that will in fact extend this requirement to 20 years. So if that is progresses through the House, then we'll need to discuss the implications for this bill. But it's also around the next requirement, which is around the 5 years above 50. So this idea that you have to go back to your home country or you have to stay in New Zealand over 50 years of age in order to qualify for the pension. This bill essentially does away with that, so that people from Niue, Cook Islands or Tokelau may go back to their countries, contribute to their local economies and also fulfil the requirements for the New Zealand Super or pension. Now, Madam Speaker, other options were considered in the Select Committee process, you know, and so the option that was really chosen by the Select Committee was an option that removes the disincentives for people to move to the islands and to contribute to their local economy. But it's also the option that retains the core principles of New Zealand superannuation, which means that you must stay here for a certain number of years and work here in New Zealand, but you also must work in these countries in order to satisfy the requirements. And because of our special relationship, Madam Speaker, it is believed that if you're in the realm, no matter where you are, you're fulfilling the requirements for this bill. So that was the option that the Select Committee chose for this. I do want to go through some of the submissions from the Select Committee. You know, essentially, we did receive 7 submissions in total. Not a lot, but certainly very substantial and high quality submissions at that. 2 of those submissions were received orally, and I was there at that meeting, Madam Speaker, where we heard them, one of those from the High Commissioner to this area. And essentially, Madam Speaker, there were 3 key arguments that were raised against this bill. The first is that there is potential to discriminate in this bill for those that are from this realm versus those that are not from this realm. And I want to assure the submitters that this bill doesn't in fact discriminate, that anybody, no matter where you are from, can move to these countries after you're 50. So perhaps you've come from South Africa, for example. We've got a lot of South Africans in my electorate. So you've come from South Africa, you come from South Africa at 45, you work right up until 50, and you decide, well, Niue, Tokelau and Cook Islands, they're beautiful places to live, and maybe I'd like to retire there. So it gives these people the opportunity to actually go to these countries and also to fulfil the requirements for their New Zealand Super or a veteran's pension. So in fact, that doesn't discriminate, Madam Speaker. The second point that was raised in the Select Committee submissions is that there would be an unfair advantage from people from those islands. And I've just demonstrated, Madam Speaker, that there will not be, in fact, an unfair advantage from these islands. The final thing that was raised, Madam Speaker, was around the economic impact of this bill, and that there was a sense that Madam Speaker was so engrossed in my speech that she forgot to do the buzzer. that the economic value would actually be harmed from this bill. And Madam Speaker, I want to assure the submitters that I actually think the opposite. This bill has the potential to add a significant amount of economic value to these countries through remittances and also through the economic activity of these people in these countries while they're fulfilling the requirements for their pension. So there you have it, Madam Speaker. That is the major flaws that were raised in the submission process, and I've managed to dispel some of those. I'd like to spend the last kind of minute just talking about the Select Committee, and I'd like to thank all the members on the Select Committee for their tiresome work in hearing the submissions. They were tireless. Thank you to my colleague, Brett Hudson. It has been a long week. And I'd just like to say, Madam Speaker, that this is a good bill. And it's a good bill that I believe is going to get Bill is going to get a lot of support in the House, and I'm looking forward to seeing all of those people who contribute to New Zealand's economy also to be able to access New Zealand
Thank
Super.
You very
Thank
much.
You, Madam Speaker.
Speaker.
I understand this is a split call. Greg O'Connor, you have 5 minutes.
Here we go. Madam Speaker, I'm confident you